In this problem, we have a CSTR that's very non-ideal. So when we do a tracer experiment, we don't get the behavior you expect from an ideal CSTR. In this particular case, we do a step function tracer, which means we increase the concentration from zero to a constant value at time equals zero, and then we observe the response at the output. And that's shown in the figure. The question then is, can we develop a model, physical view of the system that consists of combinations of ideal reactors, recycle, bypass, and holdup, doesn't necessarily have to include all of these, that would give us a similar tracer output? And then if we can do that, what are the values for the parameters in order to fit this behavior, given that the total reactor volume is 1.5 liters and the inlet volumetric flow rate is a tenth of a liter per minute? And then finally it says, can we sketch the exit age distribution for this non-ideal reactor? So the exit age distribution corresponds to what would be the tracer response if I did a pulse input instead of a step function input. The input I've drawn here, the black line, where at time equals zero, up until then, there's no tracer. At time equals zero, the tracer concentration jumps to a constant value, showing a normalized tracer concentration. And now if we look at our output, we immediately see 30% of the tracer coming through at a constant value. So this would indicate there's no holdup time for this 30%. It's essentially bypassing our system. And then the rest is going in to a reactor. We can start drawing what we might imagine this combination of reactors would be where we have a bypass. So I've started to draw the diagram where we have 0.1 liters per minute coming into the reactor. And we're going to now have that come into our model of the non-ideal reactor. And then 0.03 liters per minute, 30% is bypassing. So this is the bypass. The response we see is there's a delay time of 5 minutes, and then we get behavior that is exponential, which is the kind of behavior you would expect for a CSTR. So this delay time of 5 minutes is what we'd expect from a plug flow reactor. So it appears we have a plug flow reactor in series with the CSTR. The rest that's not being bypassed, that 70%, first goes through a plug flow reactor. It has a residence time of 5 minutes. And then we go through a CSTR. And then the exponential term, notice that we have T minus 5. That's accounting for the delay due to plug flow reactor. 8 then is the residence time. Tau for the CSTR is 8 minutes. And now we can, from our flow rates and our times, calculate the volumes of the plug flow reactor and the CSTR to determine if we've modeled the system. I've used the definition for residence time, which is the volume of the reactor or the volumetric flow rate here. And I've rearranged, substitute in the values to calculate the volume of the plug flow reactor and the volume of the CSTR. Now our total volume is 1.5 liters, so that's the volume of the plug flow reactor plus the volume CSTR, the bypass we assume has no volume. That's not going to add up to 1.5 liters, which means we must have some holdup, namely some region in the real CSTR that's just not mixed, that's stagnant because of not proper design of the stirrers and the baffles. We can now calculate the volume of the holdup. The volume of the holdup is 0.59 liters. The diagram here certainly is not to scale in terms of the size of the reactors. The largest volume is the holdup, the next largest is CSTR, and the smallest is the plug flow. But this then would give us a response to the step function input that we measure. In the process, we've determined the parameters, namely the volumes of each of the parts and the fraction that's bypassed. The last part of the problem then is, what is the exit age distribution? Which is the same as asking for this system, what's the response to a pulse input? So if we have a pulse input, what's going to happen is, if we put a pulse here, we immediately see 30% of the pulse appearing at the detector bypass, assuming zero transient time through the bypass. We then see a delay before the pulse is going to appear in the output because of the plug flow reactor. And after that delay, we get the normal CSTR response for this particular volume. And so we won't do the numbers for this. We'll just look at what the behavior would be. So for a pulse input at time equals zero, what we would see then is 30% of this pulse immediately appearing out the output, and the area, ideal pulse, infinite height and infinitesimal width, but the area would be proportional to 30% of the total amount of the pulse. The remaining 70% would exhibit a delay time due to the plug flow reactor, so we'd see a pulse and then we would see nothing until 5 minutes. At 5 minutes, the pulse would be injected into the CSTR, and we'd have the maximum concentration of CSTR, and then we would see this exponential decay corresponding to that residence time of 8 minutes as the tracer concentration of CSTR decreases. So this is the exit age distribution, or is often called the residence time distribution, for this 9-ideal CSTR that has hold up, bypass, and a plug flow reactor section in series with the well mix section.